Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Marathon Mondays with Mal. It's a Coburg morning here at the world headquarters of Marathon Coach, and I've got the 2019 calendar. All right, here's the deal. We're already in September or October, whenever this is going to air, but the calendar, as you know, is something that we spend a lot of resources on and time. Look at this beautiful cover. I think you remember from a Marathon Mondays where we showed the cover shoot. And we're talking October. We're gonna talk October of the 2020 calendar. Now, Coach 1297, you guys know this coach. This is a X3 bunk coach, double slide. This is the coach that I took down to Los Angeles about 3 weeks ago. It's gonna be in a TV show, which is exciting. I'll be able to tell you about that later. I can't say a thing about it until that show airs. But what I can show you is exactly what the marketing team is doing this morning on Coach 1297 to get ready for October of 2020's calendar month. Let's go take a look. So, you guys know that we do some themed shows, You know that we do some themed months. Last year we did St. Patrick's Day, we've done Thanksgiving, we did Christmas. Usually we do Christmas every year. It's gonna be Halloween, October 2020. So let's take a look. As you can see, there's lots of infrastructure out here to get set up. Wait till you go inside Coach 1297 and see what the marketing team is doing, and you'll see how in-depth they go to get this coach themed for Halloween. One of the things that'll stand out right away to you is that guy right there.
Oh, and this isn't just anything.
What is when that? Tell us what it is.
When we unroll this, you've seen bearskin rug.
Yes.
You know, like the Addams Family, when you've got the actual bear head still attached to the rug. Well, this is a werewolf rug. So once we unroll this, it's the whole rug with the werewolf head, and we're going to lay him right down the middle.
Oh, that's great. Well, Pete, say hi to the Marathon Monday crew.
Howdy.
Pete, tell us, we've been in here with you before for a Christmas and Easter. We had the live bunnies.
Yeah, that's right.
For Easter last year. Tell us what your concept is for October 2020 calendar.
All right. So we did Halloween few years back. We're bringing it back in this calendar for 2020. This time though, instead of the whimsical with yes. the lighthearted stuff, we're not going grody, but we are going to go Addams Family style.
Like
so
it.
It's gothic without the gross. I think the grossest we go is the skeletons, but they're nice and dry. There's nothing nasty.
Absolutely.
So. But yeah, it's,
show us some of your favorite things that you've picked out. And I can tell you guys that he's been selecting these items for over a year.
So first, this is something I love. We wanted to do bottles of Dracula's bottles of vintage blood type thing. So
right.
We tried to find the most gothic. You won't really see these in the pictures, but from a distance, they're gothic.
Yes, look at that.
Yeah, so we found some of the most gothic,
old-looking crow's feet, candlestick holders.
Yeah, Mickey and I bought all this stuff almost a year ago now.
I've seen that it's been sitting in your office and in different areas. There's a crow over here. Here's a snake coming out of a tea kettle.
Yeah, and of course, this bit of a broomstick. This, we're going to put something else on top of it, probably something like this, and make it kind of look like, of course, those are olives, but,
The
wrong light and the wrong topper.
Or the right light.
Or the right light. It becomes kind of more like something, let your imagination run wild.
Absolutely.
So,
cool. I saw there's a rat down there on the floor.
There's
big spiders, these big furry spiders. Look in the decor, Armand, back here. You can see there's a skeleton head placed up there.
We're just getting
going. You guys are just getting started. Now, how long does this process take?
Well, from unpack, set up, photograph, tear it all down, clean up, it's at least a 3-day project.
Gotcha.
It's huge.
Yeah, you've got a lot of things in here. I see this side chair. This looks great.
The side chair is almost done. This is where we started. This will be part two. We're gonna put a big dead bouquet here. We haven't figured out all the stuff, but we'll probably put a little poison label on this. This is a little tribute to the to lurch on.
Oh yeah.
Is that his name?
Did I get it right? You rang.
Yes, that's
yeah,
the guy.
For sure.
I always get it confused between the two, but anyway, they would always kill their houseplants.
Absolutely.
So, you know, it's...
Well, and let's talk about the marketing behind the calendar. The calendar's been going on for, quite frankly, decades.
Yep.
If you go into Pete's office, underneath his desk, he's got all the calendars that go back to the 1980s. Pete, talk to us about the importance of the marathon calendar.
That's a good thing. So there's a lot of reasons why we do this and put so much effort into it. We put more effort into this print piece than any other print piece we do. And it is a lot of things for us.
Yes.
It is not just
a
calendar.
What's a lot of things for a lot of people, not just the company?
For instance, if you're going to go buy a custom coach, you want to pick out a paint job, what kind of paint job do you like? What kind of interior do you like? What kind of colors? This is a great flip book to try and look what people have done. We always include the custom coaches from the year.
Yes.
So if you want to see what somebody has done that's not what necessarily Marathon picked, but it's what a person did for themselves,
sure,
that's in here. We've got, this is also in a way our brochure. We've got people that received this for years, and when they reached that point in their life that they could afford it, they bought, and they religiously got this. So it is many things to us.
Well, I love the fact that we still do it, because in an era of electronic brochures, go to my website, go to our website, let me email that to you. In an era where we do a lot of that emailing or that electronic media, we still produce an absolute beautiful quality calendar. And I love the fact that it's something that someone can actually sit in their coach or in their home or take to coffee and show their friends some of the beautiful things of the coach.
I should also mention, this is the most personal project to the owner of the company, Steve Shelhorn.
Gotcha.
He's extremely involved with this. He approves the whole thing front and back. He reviews it several times. The cover shot in particular for him is incredibly important. We put a lot of effort into making it just right.
Well, and some of the elements that you're using for decor, Steve contributed himself, correct?
That's right. As a matter of fact, they're due here today in the mail. That will all go back along the shelf in the bedroom area. It's this neat little spooky town, mini buildings and everything. So yes, you're right. He takes a really personal view on all this. There we go.
I like it. Very nice. Pete, thank you so much.
You betcha.
Before we sign off, let's go back to the back here. We've got Mickey, Adam, and Sarah back here. I don't know what they're working on. I do see that there's a pumpkin head dead guy here in the top bunk. That's pretty creative.
We haven't said
that. That looks like something Adam would have done. Here we are in the back. Guys, oh my gosh. Mickey the Crow. Tell us about what's going on back here. What are you guys working on?
Lots of tag pulling right
Taking
now.
Taking the tags off.
Yeah. You can't have an exposed tag in a photo shoot.
Well, just like a finished coat.
Attention to the details, that's right.
Yeah.
So, what are some of your favorite elements, you guys, that is going to be in this shoot?
In here.
I think that the skeletons are going to bring a lot.
Yes.
The kind of finished look of everything.
Yeah, and they add a large... Hey, this could be a microphone. Okay, so aside from that, as you can see, there's so much that goes into doing this calendar shoot, and we don't want to give you all of the things that they're doing, because that would kind of disrupt what we usually do with the calendar, and that's make it a surprise for you guys. So we're going to get out of here so as not to show too much, because they're just in the process of setting things up and getting everything set up together. So thanks, you guys.
Thanks,
Mal.
Bye, Mal.
So, you guys already know how excited I am about the calendar, and when we go in depth like this to do something so themed, I love it, because it shows the commitment that Marathon has to the marketing side, which is extremely important of selling a Marathon coach. All right. So we're gonna, and here is the skeleton dog and the skeleton cat. In fact, I think this guy, yes, he actually talks. Does this cat talk? My goodness. Well, that being said, I guess that's going to be about it for this morning's Marathon Mondays. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for showing so much interest in our show. Thank you for going to YouTube. Don't forget to go to YouTube, search out Marathon Coach, and follow our page on YouTube. Don't forget Marathon Mondays with Mal on Facebook, Marathon Coach on Facebook. And while you're at it, Randy and Dawn and a Marathon Coach, they're out there also. Check out their page. If you don't know how to find it, email me at malw@marathoncoach.com. I'll help you find it. Thank you for watching. Be yourself and do good things. And for those of you who are scared by this, there's more freakiness to come to Coach 1297 for the Halloween shoot. Take care, everybody.